Hi, I'm Doug Jewett.
And I'm Norm Rice.
Election Day is Tuesday, and up until now, we've been accused of running a somewhat humorless campaign.
So we decided to get together and tell a couple of jokes to add a little humor to the elections.
After you, Norm.
No, Doug, after you.
No, after you.
Doug, I insist, after you.
Okay, okay. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
A system of mandatory school busing that is ruining the educational quality of Seattle public schools.
A system of mandatory busing who?
You.
You. Yeah. All right, I have one. I've got one. Why did the city attorney cross the road?
I give up.
Because he lacked the skills to bring the people together. He didn't know how to bring the people together. So that's why he crossed the road.
Well, just a couple of funnies there. Don't forget, vote this Tuesday.
This coming Tuesday. Doug, you have something on your tie here.
Hey, watch it. Stop it.
Welcome to Almost Live, jam-packed with swell stuff like Speedwalker and Uncle Buzz and a lot more.
Why, time will seem to just race by on Almost Live. And now, here he is, John!
That's great, that's great. I know we're all excited here because, you know, the big election is coming up on Tuesday. And remember, it's very important to be an informed voter. Read your voter's pamphlet. We had Almost Live, we read ours, and we thought it was great as far as it went, but there's something missing. It tells you who the candidates are, what office they're seeking, but there's no job descriptions. It doesn't tell you what they're supposed to do once they get elected. So we thought we could help clear up the confusion. Follow along as we present the Almost Live political job guide. For example, the mayor rides in the front of the Seafair parade. He gets photographed with the Ballard Oyster Queen and plans his Senate career. Members of the school board, they make sure that wiener winks and beans are served only once a week. They ensure that Seattle teachers know all 26 letters of the alphabet in order. And they make sure the song Tequila is not played more than 3 times during a single football game. The Secretary of State writes the voter's pamphlet. He negotiates arms treaties with Iowa. And he's got to figure out what to do with all the leftover centennial souvenirs. The Treasurer keeps the combination to the big safe. The King County Executive begs the Mariners to stay, begs the Supersonics to stay, and begs the Seahawks to stay. Go Hawks, go Hawks. Okay. The Port Commissioner lets ships park for $3 all evening and keeps the liquor cabinet stocked on the Washington State ferries. Yay. City Council members grow old and die. Okay, the Sewer District Commissioner. Now, this was an interesting one to us because we thought, do we really have to have an election, you know, for this one? I mean, if somebody wants to do this, can't we just let them do it? I mean, as long as they've got, you know, a rooter snake, if they own one, can't we just let them do it? Then we actually looked in the voter's pamphlet, and we found here that this candidate, we have a shot of this here, this candidate forgot to submit his photo or his statement. Now, isn't that the kind of person you want running the sewers? Let's see. Did I change those filters? Did I turn that valve? Well, you know, you be the judge. Anyway, read the pamphlet. Well, as you know, Almost Live is a state-of-the-art show. And I think we have a first for you. We have taken a few members of our audience, miniaturized them, and injected them directly into my bloodstream. I think we can get a shot of them now. Do we have a shot of them in there? Are they in there now? Wait a minute. Are they in there? Oh, there they are. There they are. Coursing through. It's great. Look at that blood. Isn't that great? No cholesterol there. That's great. They're having a great time, of course. They're having a great time. Of course, when they reach the valves of my heart, they'll be crushed to death. But, you know, small price to pay for immorality. Immorality. Good. Immortality. And immorality. Doesn't matter. Now, one of the big issues that's coming up in the election this year, of course, is crime. We take a real strong standing on that. We feel that's a serious issue, and thereby we want to present another issue of our own physically fit superhero for the 90s, Speedwalker.
Jeff Bimmel, reporter for the Daily Dealer. Today's assignment, King Dogs. It started out as a routine story, but then...
Attention, citizens of Seattle. I'm gonna blow up the kingdom with a big bomb.
A bomb! Quick, call the mayor! Call the chief of security! Call anybody! We need some help! Please help us! Call the state patrol! Call the police!
This looks like a job for...
We need help! We need some help here! Call the police! Call the mayor! That's who! Call the mayor! Call Tim Hill!
Speed Walker!
Yes, it's Speed Walker, the physically fit superhero who fights crime while maintaining strict adherence to the regulations of the International Speed Walking Association. Heel toe, Speed Walker!
See your ticket stub, punk?
Who are you?
I'm Speedwalker.
Yes, Chief.
Okay. Officer, here's someone I think you'd like to meet. It's your gridiron culprit.
Thanks, Speedwalker. You're under arrest.
I've got a bomb to take care of.
Thanks again, Speedwalker.
That should hold it for a while.
What happened, officer?
We had a bomb in the kingdom, but Speedwalker saved the day.
I'm Jeff Bimmel from the Daily Dealer. Tell me all about it.
You should have seen Speedwalker. He come roaring in here, he took care of the problem, he beat the police.
Okay, stay with us. We got a great show tonight. We got Uncle Buzz. We got lots of stuff. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Gentlemen, I think we're all very close to an agreement now. If we can just iron out a few of these final details, we can all get back to work building airplanes.
Yes, yeah, let's get it over with. I got the King Dome book next week. The whole union's going to be there. I want to go back to my machinists with a final contract.
All right, I think we can compromise.
No compromise! No compromise! Oh. Okay, okay. What's your offer?
All right, look. You've got to go into the King Dome next week. You need entertainment. If you sign the agreement as it is now, we'll bring in a tractor pull.
No way. No way.
All right. We'll add some car-crushing monster trucks.
No.
All right, our final offer. A tractor pull, monster trucks, and a dollar off on all King beers. All day.
Deal.
Dollar
that's
off.
A deal.
All right,
deal.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, hold it. Okay, we need more money. We still need more money.
More money? Why? Look, let's look at the workload. We have those documents here. I think we have. Where are those documents? Where are they? Where are they? All right. There. All right, where are they? All right. Yes, riveter. Now, how many people does it take to put in one rivet?
Well, okay. There's the guy who puts in the rivet, and there's a guy watching him. Third guy to inspect the work. Then there's two guys watching him, two guys to handle the coffee fund, and then a guy to organize a football pool, and then five managers.
Well, look, can't you have one of the guys who's working on the coffee fund also do the football pool?
What? That would put us right back in the Stone Age. Why don't you have one of your managers help out a little bit?
What are you talking about? Why? We need five managers. You got to have, look, we've got a production manager, a process manager, a quality assurance manager, the manager to train the other managers, and the interim manager in case one of the others gets sick. I mean, look, you've already squeezed us enough. You're asking us to cut back a manager. What are you trying to do? You're squeezing blood out of us. Forget it. We won't do it.
Okay. How about if you take your interim standby alternate manager, okay, and have him be a riveter when he's not being a manager. You could double production for the same amount of money.
All right. I think we can make a deal on that, but no coffee detail. He's still management. No coffee work.
Even when he's a riveter?
That's right, absolutely.
Okay, but he'll take his tie off.
No. We'll stand very firm on that. No, we're very firm on that.
Okay. It's a deal.
All right.
Okay.
Great. All right. Very good. Thanks. Congratulations, gentlemen. My signature? There. You just sign right there.
Okay, where do I sign here?
Right there. Sign right there.
Okay. Oh, break time. Sorry. Ah.
Thank you. We're back. And now please welcome Seattle's favorite children's entertainer, Uncle Buzz.
I'm sorry I'm late. I don't know where I was. Fact of the matter is, people have been asking me where I've been for the last couple of months, and I don't have a clue. Look, if you saw me walking around, maybe I was by a railroad trestle or something. If you saw me, call me. I don't need to know, I'm just kind of curious. I don't know where I was. Look, let's get right to it, shall we? Let's take our first phone call. Hi, you're on the air with Uncle Buzz.
Hi, Uncle Buzz. I'm a big fan.
Oh, yeah?
And a long-time listener.
I've only been on for about 30 seconds.
Well, I've been listening since then.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Can you remember where you were during the big Seattle earthquake?
Look, I can't remember that at all. Not a bit of it. No way.
Well, where were you when Mount St. Helens erupted?
Like I said, I'm not good at remembering stuff.
What about when you first heard they were going to sell Coors in Washington State?
I was with a friend. I was in his apartment at Fremont. I'll never forget that. Well, that was a night. By the way, we have a 7-second delay tonight. Okay, sorry for the delay. Let's get on with it, shall we? This is Uncle Buzz. You're on the air.
Yeah, hi. My name's Todd, and I'm in the eighth grade.
Great.
I was out on the playground today, and this kid started calling me names and making fun of me in front of my other friends.
Uh-huh.
Do you think I should pound him?
I don't think you should pound people when you're in the eighth grade. You've got to get along with other eighth graders.
No, no, I'm an eighth grader. He's just a third grader.
Oh, you should pound him.
Oh, thanks,
yeah.
man.
Yeah, yeah. You got to pound guys like that, definitely. Let's go to our next call, shall we? Wonder what these are. Yeah.
Hi, man. Hey, I can belch the Blue Danube Waltz.
You can belch it?
Yeah, check it out.
Okay. Let's say we put him on hold for a while, huh? Let's hop to the other line. Hi, you're on the air with Uncle Buzz.
Yeah, this is Bobby Bibble, Buzz.
Uh-huh.
I was wondering what you think about the boring Brian Bosworth business, Buzz Buddy.
That Boz babble is a bona fide bummer, Bobby Booby.
So Boz is beached, Buzz?
The big brass broke the bank with a big bunch of bonus bucks, betting Boz was bound to bust buns, blast, block, and blitz, but he's been a bit of a bomb. Right, Tony?
Bingo, Buzzy boy. The bubbles burst on this Boz biz. The bearing better bite the bullet and bag billion-buck bonus, baby, because Big Boz bounce back is just a bogus.
So what you're telling me, Tony, is that Brawny Beefy Boz's big boasts have been a big bust at best, buddy.
Been a big boo-boo, Buzz.
Yeah, thanks, Tony. Boy, those 35 rehearsals sure pay off, don't they? I have no idea what he's doing here this evening. Let's take another call. You're on the air. Hello.
Yes, sir. I'd like to ask you a question,
All right. I'll
just hang up and then listen to your answer off the air.
Fantastic.
Yes, sir. What's the difference between the greenhouse effect and the ozone thing?
Okay.
I'll just hang up.
You're gonna hang
up?
Okay. Have you hung up already?
Yes, I have.
Okay. Now, the greenhouse deal, I'm not sure what that is. I think it's some kind of a gardening deal. But you can find out all about ozones if you would go to your sex education class. That's where I found out about it. Let's check back with that guy, shall we? Back to line three now. You're on the air with Uncle Buzz.
Hi. Can I get your opinion?
Yeah, you got a weird voice.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
You're welcome. Line two. Hi, you're on the air.
Yes, sir. Nobody likes me.
Is that
they
right?
don't want me around.
Uh-huh.
They say I've got the habit of repeating everything anybody says.
You repeat what they say?
I repeat what they say.
Whatever they say.
Whatever they say.
You repeat.
I repeat.
Can't help you.
Can't help me?
I gotta go now. Yeah. Compelling individual. I think he's a guy that repeats things a lot. And he also repeats stuff a lot. I find it very irritating. I don't know what the excitement is about these snossages. Dogs love them, but... They don't do much for me. If you people like to help yourself, you're certainly welcome. Back to the phone. Hi. Yeah. Let's take our last call of the evening, shall we?
Hi, Buzz. This is Roxanne. I've been listening to you, and I just wonder what you look like.
Well,
you know, I like tall guys. How tall are you?
About 6'8", 7 feet.
Do you dress really nice, and are you really well-groomed?
Yeah, I think that's important to be groomed.
Well, do you have really nice hair?
I'd say that's my nicest feature, yeah.
Well, you know, that's not what I pictured at all.
What'd you picture?
Well, I thought you'd be sort of 45 years old and greasy, you know, kind of a gross scumbag, and somebody who never showered and really smelled bad.
Yeah, well, you couldn't be more wrong, baby.
Bye, cutie.
Yeah. Bye, sweetheart. This way. Good night, I'm Uncle Buzz.
And now, the lame list, or What's Weak This Week, brought to you by Seattle's heavy metal community.
Lame.
R-rated movies with no nudity.
Lame.
Very lame.
Double lame, triple lame.
Bellevue girls with attitudes.
Lame-ish.
Donny Osmond in leather. Utah.
Oh, lame.
M-80s with short fuses.
That's very lame. Very lame.
Girls who get mad if you pass out.
Lame.
Lame.
This has been The Lame List.
All right, we had fun. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.